These were homes where children ran and laughed, where families would come together for comfort and safety. In a five-day time frame, hundreds of civilians were killed in western Mosul. And we went to a hospital in Erbil to look for some of the survivors. Aliya was cradling her granddaughter, Hawra, who's just 4.5 years old. It was March 17th, which is the main day under investigation by both the U.S. and Iraqi governments. Hawra's father, Ala, drew their street for us, showing us where the ISIS fighters were on the corner. There were multiple explosions. Hawra was in a home down the road with her mother and two relatives. They were baking bread when the airstrike started. Hawra's father ran towards the house. His daughter's little body was black. It was barely recognizable. After Ala pulled her out of the rubble, he begged the ISIS fighters to be allowed to leave just for the sake of saving his little girl. On a different day, Mohammed stuck his head out the front door when an airstrike came in to take out a suicide car bomb. Now he has shrapnel lodged in his head. He can't talk. He's lost his memory. Down the hall in another ward, we found a bunch of children. Fatma, she's just 16. She lived in an apartment block and was on the second floor. Her back is broken. She probably won't ever walk again, but no one has the heart to tell her. And she still has dreams of being a doctor. She's here with her sister, whose son was also injured. Much of western Mosul has been physically destroyed. People are dying every day. Coalition airstrikes, mortars, sniper shots, ISIS explosions. Deaths that don't make headlines. Its population is emotionally shattered. And they're haunted by the ghosts of those who are gone. Hawra doesn't know her mother's dead. She still has shrapnel in her eye. She may never see again. Don't say you're sorry, her father told us. Sorrow doesn't help. It's not going to bring her mother back. Arwa Damon, CNN, Erbil, Iraq.